Hello, friends. This is Dave Hurwitz, executive editor at ClassicsToday.com, here with something of a follow-up to my previous video on why classical music is the greatest music of all, better than all of that other stuff, I said at the time, and caused something of a furor. The furor was based on, well, there were a couple of factors, three of them, I think, actually, if I want to spell it out in detail, and I want to address them because I think it's important. I think it's important to understand what we're doing here and why. And the factor number one was that I did not mention when I was talking about how fabulous classical music is compared to all other kinds, other cultures which have their own classical musics. Well, they do and they don't. I'm not going to get into the definition of what is classical. I would call it more indigenous music, music that is not based on the Western system of musical notation and harmony and counterpoint and all the things that make Western music, Western music. And yes, it is true. There are many, 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 many other cultures that have many, 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 many other kinds of music. And some of those kinds of music do some of the things that Western classical music does. That is, they have form, they have lengthy pieces, they do all kinds of stuff. And some of those cultures wrote music that I particularly enjoy. I love Balinese music. I like Chinese opera. I like Indian classical music. I've been through all of this. I've had my, what we call, world music period. And, you know, in your world music period, you sample things from other cultures and you'd see what you like and what you don't like. And that's what I did, like so many other people who just love music. And if you love music as I love music, then you're going to find many, many things in music of other places that you're going to find fabulous. It's absolutely fabulous. But that has nothing to do with the objective, factual evaluation of what Western classical music does. And Western classical music, I maintain, is special. It's special in many ways. The way that I particularly spoke about at the time was form. And the evidence for that was that when people from other cultures often, and particularly our culture, wish to write pieces in larger forms, they turn to the forms of classical music. Not because those forms are elitist or snobbish or intellectual or any of those things, because they are the logical, sensible, natural ways of writing music in large forms that have evolved over time, thanks to the opportunities afforded by these circumstances of Western musical culture. I would think that that's an obvious point. But it seems it was not. And for many people, the fact that I didn't talk about other indigenous cultures and their musics was a form of colonialism or imperialism or bigotry even. Someone called me a bigot for, you know, daring to suggest that Western classical music was in some way special. All I was doing was making a list of its factual, objective musical qualities that are not shared in toto by any of those other musics. That's the truth. I'll give you another example. There is no ensemble, ensemble of musical instruments, musical organization that has more color, more range, more expressive potential, more flexibility than the symphony orchestra, period. There isn't anything in the world remotely similar. Not gamelan ensembles, not Japanese koto ensembles, not the court orchestras of Thailand and other places. They're beautiful. They're lovely. They play lovely music, but they don't have a patch on what a symphony orchestra can do. It is one of the most remarkable evolutions or organizations, whatever you want to call it, in the entire history of humanity, and nothing matches it. Is that controversial? I don't know. I would think not. I would think that it's a self-evident point. You know, the other thing that really sort of got me about the comments is the objection to judging, to deciding that this thing is better than that thing. Well, here's a news flash. I'm a critic. It's what I do. I love doing it. It's fun to do. And if something comes along that's better than something Western, I am more than happy to give it credit because I don't have a bias for Western things. I mean, I may be biased to the extent that, you know, my own experience in life inclines me more to some things than other things. That's unavoidable. It's a natural thing. But my effort is devoted to finding and talking about the best of whatever it happens to be. I don't have biases towards Western musicians versus Eastern musicians. I don't have biases towards Western products versus Eastern products. I mean, I'm a pretty good Thai cook. When the Japanese started making cars, I bought two of them. Why? Because they were better. And the idea that, you know, something is better than something else, that it was better value, that it was better put together, that it was better something, nobody has any problem with it in their normal daily lives. Why then do we have a problem with it when we talk about cultural products? It is not imperialism or colonialism to assert that some of the products of Western culture are fabulous, the best in class, and that's it. They are. People can't deal with that, particularly today, where it's politically incorrect to suggest that one thing is better than another thing. God forbid, because that's somehow evil. It's a nefarious plot. I mean, somebody actually suggested in the comments that, I mean, you know, it's really a no-win situation, it seems, sometimes, if you're talking about Western cultural products or artistic products. First of all, people suggest it's all subjective. Well, no, it isn't subjective. Music is a thing. Music operates by certain rules. Some of those rules are definable. The products of those rules are describable, and they have certain qualities. And the quality that I adduce for greatness is ability to absorb influences and constantly create something new and fresh and wonderful. And Western classical music has that. It absolutely has that. Other musics may or may not, but most of them, in my experience, cannot absorb elements of Western classical music and remain what they are because they are narrowly defined. Western classical music is openly defined. And that is an aspect of its greatness, the fact that it has this openness to all kinds of elements that you can take ideas, musical ideas, objects, processes from anywhere. You can take Hindu tala, the rhythmic formulas of Indian classical music, and stuff them into the Tarangalela Symphony, and it's fabulous. You can take Arabic intonational scales. You can take mean tone temperament. You can do anything you want and still write a concerto, a symphony, a sonata, something. You could create an American gamelan, as Lou Harrison did, with spare parts and metal objects, and then write a concerto for violin, an American gamelan. I mean, all of these things attest to the openness of the American, not the American, the Western, pardon me, classical music tradition. Now, what I was saying, though, what I was getting at was that in some respects, whenever we talk about these subjects, for some people, you are damned if you do and damned if you don't. Because one of those people was talking about how, well, yes, Western music, Western popular music particularly, has become the world standard. Everybody's doing it. They're adapting it to their own native traditions. And they do. But the result is recognizably Western popular music, not so much their native tradition, because of the need to, for example, write harmony or write counterpoint or simplify rhythms or use electronic instruments or do whatever they have to do to make something popular out of whatever their native tradition is. And that was regarded as a form of cultural imperialism or colonialism. But on the other hand, when Western musicians use foreign influences or Eastern influences or some other kind of influence, well, then that's cultural appropriation when it's adapted to the means of Western classical music. So you can't win. You're damned if you do and damned if you don't. We're either colonialists or appropriationists. That's not a musical position. That says nothing about music. Zero. That's politics. And I'm not interested in politics, frankly. I'm not interested in politics when it comes to music and culture. I'm interested in talking about what makes one thing better than another thing, or what makes one thing great. That's what I'm interested in. It has nothing to do with the politics of it. It's ridiculous. That was like one major, major issue. The other issue that really got people, and I really love talking about this because it's so much fun, is the fact that I delete comments that I think are irrelevant in the comments section. One person said that I am limiting the ability to have a healthy, productive discussion about these issues by eliminating things that I consider to be irrelevant or besides the point or nasty. Well, here's another news flash. Yes, I do that. I judge. I'm an editor. It's my channel. I get to decide what people see and what people don't, what I say and what other people say. And that's the way it is. And if you don't like it, go watch someone else's channel. Make your own channel where you can have a free-for-all. The internet is absolutely full of free-for-alls where there's nothing but healthy, fair discussions where everyone can say whatever they damn well please. Well, here you can't, because I'm trying to create a record of, yes, useful discussion about the topics that we raise, about recordings, about musical works, about musical forms, about all of those things. But it's about music, not politics. So that stuff's all going to go, and I am so happy to delete it and to forestall free discussion. Nothing is free, people. You know, the idea that there is this entitlement to just say whatever you want and to post it on my channel. Oh, for heaven's sake, grow up. I love it. I love the idea that people actually say that seriously. I find it hilarious. Anyway, so that's that topic. And then the last topic that people suggested in the comments section was that by praising Western music, Western classical music, the Western classical music tradition, I am somehow being an elitist. That elitism of saying that one thing is better than another thing is exactly what turns people off to classical music. It prevents them from listening to it. Well, here's the last news flash. People want to listen to something that's great. People want something that's the best. People want something that flatters their choice, that flatters their intelligence, that flatters all of those things, that rewards them for having made a choice, for having given time to something. Now, I've always said there's only good music and bad music. I have spoken in favor of woke programming. I made a video about how Black composers matter. I talk about film music. I talk about Broadway musicals. I talk about all kinds of music. I talk about how the Beatles are classical, how things become classical. I talk about songs versus larger forms and what makes them classical and what is not. My whole concern and project is, how do we find and identify greatness? How do we recognize wonderful music wherever we find it? Music of other cultures. I mean, I've talked about gamelan music. I've talked about other musics once in a while. It's not my specialty. It's not what I'm here for. I'm here to talk about Western classical music for the most part. But the idea that is a form of elitism, well, if it is, then fine. I'm guilty. I'm an elitist. I'm totally an elitist. I'm an elitist not because I like classical music, but because I like good music. And if liking good music and trying to explain why some music is good music or why one thing is better than another thing is a form of elitism, good. We should all be doing it. It's the healthiest thing that we can possibly do. And if someone is turned off by it, if somebody wants to think that they can be moronic and like things that are stupid and ridiculous, because to say that you know something is better than something else is somehow a bad thing, please. Again, just get over it, folks, because that's what we do. That's what we're going to do. I need to close this then with a little story, which I've told before, but it's a good story, I think. And it says something about where we are with regard to this whole business of choice and criticism and deciding what is great and what is less than great or what isn't as great as the other thing. You know, when I was chairman of the Con Classical Awards, we gave an award to Daniel Barenboim's Beethoven cycle. And the year that Daniel Barenboim's Beethoven cycle, which is wonderful, by the way, came out, Claudio Abbado's really lousy DG Beethoven cycle came out. Remember that they quietly retired that one and replaced it with a remake without really telling anybody, because everybody knew it sucked. But that's not the point. The point is, we flew in Daniel Barenboim, or he was flown in, to receive this award, and he's standing there next to me, and I was presenting his award for his Beethoven cycle, and I said, we're so happy to give an award for this Beethoven cycle, which is special because it takes cognizance of the great German tradition of Beethoven performance of conductors like Furtwängler and Jochum and those people. And it's so much better, I said, than another Beethoven cycle by another major conductor, pardon me, on a certain yellow German label. So everybody knew I was talking about Abbado and Deutsche Grammophon, and Barenboim's face fell. And it was a gasp in the audience. Everyone was like, how could you say that, you know? And I just looked at everybody and I said, relax, folks, this is what we do. He's getting an award because he's better than the other guy. That's it. I mean, that's the reason. We can say one thing is better than the other thing. And the world is not going to come to an end. And it doesn't have to be a function of elitism or imperialism or colonialism or any other ism other than the desire to recommend the best quality music to the largest number of people who are interested in finding the best quality, the greatest music, for the reasons that we determine and define that particular aspect of greatness. Western classical music, we are lucky. We're lucky because we've got the best. Damn the rest of the world, we've got the best. It's something that evolved in the West. There are things that did not evolve in the West that we don't have the best. I mean, many things, and I wouldn't argue with that. Cultural objects, things in other forms of art. But when it comes to music, boy, are we lucky. And whether we should be, we shouldn't be patting ourselves on the back and lording it over other cultures. Of course not. The evidence is simply that the Western musical culture, popular and classical, has come to dominate the world of music. And the fact that it dominates the world of music speaks for itself. It is universal in its potential reach. It is incomparable in its richness and range of expression. It is absolutely, positively the most extraordinary thing ever devised in terms of its formal processes, its notational elegance, all of those things. And damn it, I'm happy to tell you that. And if people don't like it, nothing I can do. But you're not going to post politically correct nastiness on my channel, because that's our position and I'm sticking to it. So keep on listening, friends. Thanks so much for joining me. Take care.